come back to Dawn of Sorrow. Actually, quite near the end of the game now. Kind of snuck up on me. Anyways, yeah, sorry there hasn't been any videos these past few days. But, I've been a bit ill. And Gon hasn't been able to be over, so I haven't been able to get any recordings from that, from him either. And yeah, there's only two more map sections left to go before we've been through the entire game. And only three more boss battles. Oh, gods. It's probably just as well, given the amount of lag we're getting here. Because this is terrible. Where the warp room is in this section. Should be down at the bottom. There's a lot of stuff around here that does poison. Oh yeah, and there's this guy who, you hit him and he becomes stupidly powerful. It's like the guys with the spears who, again, if you deal enough damage, they throw away the spear and just slap you with the beak. Or is that if you do any damage at all? This has to be, because the save room's down at the bottom near the boss room. To check something, and also so we stock up on equipment and save. So, ammo, give me some potions, like all of them. Blah. Give me all the potions and all the high potions and all the anti-venoms and all the uncursed potions, and then I'll sort off. Let's go talk to Yoko. Can't remember what soul I need next for the axe. Lilith. No, I need Dragahanzo for that. But for the final guard, of course. And then after that, I will need Death to get it to its final form. But I think at this point, I'm probably better off just getting Dragahanzo across. And the dude who flies around at the bottom of the Tower of. The Condemned Tower. Tower of Judgment. It's the Mines of Judgment. There. Okay. Judgment. Also, the last warp room will be passing for quite a while. Because in the Abyss, there is only one warp room, and it's right near the end. Okay. We got a save room down here. And of course we've got the save room at the top, which I completely forgot about. Alright. Wouldn't really help. And then boss room. Let's go fight death. I suspect this will lag the game out ridiculously due to the sheer amount of sprites on screen. I thought those stats that I saw in Yoko's shop were a bit weak. Okay. I'm surprised. I would have thought that attack would have lagged it out a lot more than it did. Damn it, stop some magic clones of yourself. Oh good, he's finally got his sword. And now he sends it. Oh, I thought he was going to send it bouncing around the room again. Not again, he hasn't done that yet. Oh, he's transforming. He can do enough damage. He does this. And becomes incredibly more annoying. Oh God. I hate that attack. I'll just die already. Bugger. That's why I hate that attack. Get positioned wrong. And he does it, it's pretty much game over. But the special attack all the weapons out, the regular attack and the special attack. The one for the death side is basically you summon one of those heads. Whereas with all the other axe ones, it's you teleport to stupidly high distance and then drop down. Like this. It's not all that impressive, you will agree. And of course, it's not this death that sends his side bouncing all over the room, it's Portrait of Ruin's death. Because he starts off like this, because he summons hands from little portals that either form a big circle around the entire battle. We'll grab one of your two characters and hold them while you do sod all. When he's got you like that, you can't even switch character to the other one to make it easier to break you out. Okay, heal 35. Yeah. You're starting with this, bro? take lots of damage already. Yeah, it's not going to help at all. Yeah, it gives some mind up, actually. Hurry up and give me the magic seal. There we go. Where's my pen? Just die already, you death. How is this not working? Mushrooms. That worked. Curry. Damn it, work! There we go! Die! Stupid death. Hurry up and be dead. Okay, yep. Sounds like a good attack, but it's not. It's those little white sides you summon, bug ones, that you summon during the second half. It basically summons a few of those to follow you around every time. Anyway. New map. Welcome to the Abyss. Save them. There's actually a glitch that can be done here that usually results in random quantities of random weapons, souls, and consumables. But for that, I would need. Let's see, the. Do I already have? Oh, I've got the succubus soul, so all I'd need is the. No, I don't have. Never mind. You need a weapon like the Synchrodina, whose special move is to teleport and appear behind whoever. In this case, you appear off screen and start flying upwards. But you have to be very careful with this because, odd as it may sound, it can put you above 100% map completion. And if that happens, then if you can't actually finish the game. When you get to the ending cutscene, what it is instead of everyone actually doing all their usual, well done Soma, you defeated those guys, and you're not the Dark Lord, you get a backdrop of what should be happening. And then you can just look, but you still have control of your character, you can just walk around. But it's a very useful glitch for getting, like, you know, some of the rarer souls you might need for fusion or some interesting weapons, souls you can't normally get. My favourite is that you can unlock as usable weapons and souls the equipment that everyone has during the Julius mode, which has some really bizarre effects, like the whip. Which, when you use it as Julius, it comes from your hand. When you use it as Soma, a whip suddenly materializes about a foot from your hand. Anyway, do a quick. As soon as I get back to this. There are other places you can use it, and in some cases it can be used to sequence break, like getting from the condemned tower into the first clock tower without beating Gurgoroth. At least I've heard that it can be done like that. I've never actually tried it. So I would want where are you? Succubus. Yeah, so save, just in case. And it is 1, 2, 3, jump, there we go. See, and then you just do the standard, floor slide. And you see how I'm literally floating around on the map like that. And if I pause here, for example, see, my bare fists. Alucard's sword. An item I should never be able to get. The Final Guard sword. Handgun, Gyborg. And the amounts of what you get is also randomised. So, like, see, I've got 0 Bugbear Souls, which actually means I have 10. Whack Whack Tree Souls. And souls for enemies I haven't even seen yet, like Stolas or the Arc Demon. But The Black Panther. It's one of the only non, you know, boss transport type souls that you get. Oh, Final Guard Soul, good. That you can get, which is removed from your inventory when you start a new game. Don't know why. It's not all that powerful. Okay, see, look, I've got 9 caviar and 9 foie gras. Castle Map Zero is a common thing you get with this as well. But of course, the real trick is getting back to where you start. Because among the other things that can happen when you do this, you get stuff like the loss of the ability to pause. Well, not the ability to pause, but the ability to access the pause menu. Like that, see? Oh, and your buttons stop doing what they're supposed to. Yeah, no, this is screwed up. I can't do anything more with it. So, well, I guess that's it for today. The next episode will, in all likelihood, be the last one. We just have to get through the Abyss, which is a big circular area, star-shaped. And there's only 2 bosses left, one of which is Dimitri. And the other of which is a dude who summons locusts. So, I'll see you all next time.